Hello, I am B. Mahadevan. I am a professor at Indian Institute of Management, Bangalore. I have been here for 21 years. I am a production engineer from College of Engineering, Guindy, and then I did a master's in industrial management from IIT Madras and a PhD in manufacturing system design also at IIT Madras. There are a few areas in which I have been working. Broadly, two, three of them I would like to mention. The first area is supply chain, supply procurement in an era of internet-based procurement and things like that. The second area is one to do with service design. How do you design services? And the third area is about ancient Indian wisdom and its application to contemporary issues in management. I have an interest in Sanskrit. I was in the Central Sanskrit Board. I am also a trustee in some NGOs doing some social work. Forward supply chain has been an issue of research for the last 50 years. And in the last 10 years, there is a lot of talk about reverse supply chain. What it means is, how do you take back a product which has been sold and which has been found not useful for the customer at the end of a life cycle? So talking about this reverse supply chain, let me introduce two sets of problems. The first problem is perhaps what I would call it a strategic. And the question is as follows. I think I should give a little background to this. In 1997, in Germany, there was a legislation called product take-back legislation. What it simply meant was, suppose I use a computer and after a few years I find the computer is of no use for me as a customer. If I leave the computer on the curbside and if it happens to be a Dell computer, Dell will be sued and not the customer. In other words, firms have a responsibility not only to sell, they have a responsibility to take back. Let's look at a problem in India. India is a signatory to a legislation called End of Vehicle Life legislation. And by 2015, which is just a year away from now, 95% by weight of what goes into an automobile can go only into another automobile. So what are all these saying? Then you have the e-waste, which every one of us know. So what are all these pointing to? They're trying to suggest that while we design a product, it's extremely important for us to think about how do we take it back. That's one. Secondly, how do we organize the product take back, which is what I call it as reverse supply chain. Do I collect it? Do I set up a nationwide collection mechanism? Do I use some franchisees? Do I use some third-party service providers? In which case, what is the incentive for them to really do that? And how do I make sure things come back to me? Another related problem is what I call it as orphan products. Suppose a company has gone bankrupt. There are 20,000 items that the company has produced and sold, which is lying in the market. Who is going to take it back? How are we going to enforce the product take back happens in the case of an orphan product? So all these point to policy mechanisms which the regulator must put, policy mechanisms that the firms have to put, incentive mechanisms for the trading partners to work in alignment with what is required and so on. So these are strategic issues related to reverse supply chain. Let me just talk about one operational issue. Traditionally, when you talk of supply chains, we talk about inventory control. It's all about saying, how much do I order, when do I order it, and when will the suppliers give, what is the price, and so on. Now think about this possibility that for a component that I need, I now have two sources. One source is a supplier who is giving me a new product, and another source is there is a product take back that's happening through which I can remanufacture, recover some of the components, and I also use it. So essentially what it means is, when I talk about inventory control, it's no longer sufficient for me to set a reorder level for those items which I source from a supplier. Or even when I do that choice, or when I make the decision, I must also take into consideration that there is a supply of components coming from products which are returned. So the reorder level, which is a very tactical problem, it's not a strategic problem. It's a problem that firms keep revisiting from time to time. Even this needs to be done in a manner where we gain from some of the low cost components which are returned and understand how much is the inflow of return components and use that as a basis for resetting the reorder level. So one of my research addresses that kind of problems. So there are a variety of problems like this where the world is heading towards a sustainable mode of operating. Businesses need to learn that, and if we need to do it, reverse supply chain is going to be a major issue, and problems of the kind that I introduced and some of the possibilities of addressing these problems are going to be very, very important in the days to come.